Hey guys, welcome to Breaking Feud. I just did a video on the difference between the S22 and the S21 phones. So, you know, the S22 / S22 Plus against the S21 and the S21 Plus phones. So I just did a video on that. But the reason I didn't mention the Samsung Galaxy S22 Ultra phone is because it's a whole separate video to talk about. It's a completely new phone. So let's get right into it right now. Last time we got the Note phones was in 2020. So the Note 20 came alongside with the S20 phones, but with the S21 lineup, there wasn't a Note phone. Here's the thing, recently, I don't know if the S Pen will be supported with the normal S22 phones, but I know with the S21 series and both of the folding phones that Samsung had made, you know, the Flip 3 and the Fold 3, they all supported the S Pen. Well, you have to buy the specific S Pen for that specific model from the Samsung website, and from there, buy a case just to hold it. And there was no like Note phones. So with this new phone, the S22 Ultra, is technically, literally, if you look at the phone itself, I'm telling you, Google search the video of the S22 Ultras from MKBHD and whatnot, or look at the photos. It looks like a Note phone because of the squared edges, the way the interface and everything looks like a Note phone. And it's to the point that it came with the S Pen inside the phone, which is weird. So technically the Note lineup is back in a sense. They're just axing off the lineup version and just adding it to the normal S lineup in a sense. So yeah, obviously it's kind of like a hybrid between the Note phones and the S21 Ultras, in the sense that like it's like the S21 Ultra and the Note 22 Ultras, you can't really compare the two, because in a sense that the S22 Ultra is the name for it. It's annoying to having to say that much words, but yeah, that phone, it's honestly a much better phone. Here's why. Here's the thing. So that phone comes with a pen, and it might not seem that much, but from a guy who uses an iPad with an Apple Pencil and uses his phone to edit videos and record videos, honestly, having that pen, you know, small, it, there's a saying, you know, the small things add up. So that pen, even though it's a small feature, that thing adds up. For content creators, for someone like me or other people, it's an amazing tool to get. Honestly, I will recommend that phone over the S22 phones. Honestly, comparing it to the S22 phones, I think you should spend a little bit more money on the S22 Ultra instead of the S22 phones. If you're getting the normal phones, you might as well go to the S21 phones. I know I'm kind of contradicting myself, but if you're buying, like, I don't mind if you guys get the S22, but if you're looking at the whole entire lineup itself and was wondering if you want to get the normal size, the plus version, or the S22 Ultra, I would spend big bucks on the S22 Ultra, just because it's a bigger screen. You do get better features with it, and it comes with a pen. So yeah, not just that, typically the Ultra phones tend to have better quality camera and more camera, and with it you do get a better processor, and that phone itself is just much more powerful. So if you're doing video editing, photo editing, whatnot, doing small things here and there, honestly, that phone is really powerful, like so powerful. So yeah, this is coming from a guy who is using the iPhone 12 Pro Max, one, like, it's like the top tier best phones with the best camera and best spec, and a guy who has a really budget phone, the OnePlus N200. And I'm the guy who kind of likes Android over iPhone, but in terms of like content creation, iPhone wins for me. But if I had to buy an all-in-one and I was forced into Android, the S22 Ultra is honestly the best phone, just because now recently with Samsung, they recently announced that, hey, you know, just like the Pixel and the OnePlus and like the iPhones, we're going to give many software updates. So currently it has Android 12, and the S22 lineup will last all the way to the Android 16 update. And then with the S21 phones, it will last until Android 15. And so based on that information, I will go with the S22 Ultra phone, which is honestly pretty good. Here's the thing. I mean, it has a big price tag. You might be wondering, hey, why should I pay for that much? But here's the question. How often are you going to really update your phone? And with Samsung coming out and saying, hey, you know, we're going to give these Samsung phones a lot a big software support, there's really no point to kind of, in a way, kind of like upgrade every year or every other year, honestly, at this point. I don't know, for me, I would go with that phone, but I'm still sticking with this iPhone. And for me, I'm in terms of Android side, if I do have to upgrade to a new Android phone, I will have to go with the OnePlus or Pixel, just because I do love the stock Android. I don't like the Samsung One UI, because honestly, it's just really distracting. I mean, yeah, you could put on a launcher and whatnot, but it's still not the same thing as using a built like a already pre-installed built-in, you know, stock Google, just like a Pixel and the OnePlus phones. So pretty much, yeah. So I mean, that's my opinion. I mean, it really depends on you. Based on the information I give you, make up your own decision. And please don't just buy products based on what YouTubers say. I mean, it's really up to you what you do and what you prefer. So yeah, thank you for watching this video. As always, please subscribe, click that subscribe button down below, or whatever device you're watching this on. Please give this a like and share this video with everyone else, and please share the channel with everyone else. We're trying to hit at least 100 subscribers by the end of the year. If we could, we're on 73 subscribers. So yeah, it'll be an honor to hit at least 100 subscribers by the end of this year. If we can get by the mid of this year, that would be amazing. So yeah, thank you for the support, and please stay safe.